Factor the trinomial. We have 12x squared minus 5x minus 2. Now this factoring problem is a little more complicated than the other ones because there's a number in front of the x squared besides the invisible 1. And that means there are some different possibilities. I mean, you could have, say, a 12x and an x, or it could be you have 2x, 6x, or it could be you have 3x, 4x. See, these are all the different possibilities as far as what multiplies to make 12x squared. Now you could go through and guess and check with the factors of negative 2 and all these different possibilities, but there's actually a system you can use that makes it a lot easier. Okay, now the system is called factor by grouping. So here's what you do. You multiply the first and the last term coefficients. So 12 times negative 2, that makes negative 24. And then you need to find the factors of negative 24 that add to make negative 5. Factors of negative 24. And by the way, if you have a negative 5 here, that means the bigger factor has to be negative. So you have 1 and negative 24, that doesn't work. 2, negative 12, that doesn't work. 3, negative 8, hey, that one works because those add to make negative 5. So this is going to be how you're going to split up your middle term. So you're going to rewrite as 12x squared and then plus 3x, then minus 8x, and then minus 2. Okay, so this is the first part of the factor by grouping, is you split up into the four terms that you need. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take a common factor out of the first two terms, and then a different common factor out of the last two terms. So what's in common between the 12x squared and the 3x? Well, 12 and 3 I know is a 3 in common. And then for the x's, x squared and x, there's an x in common. So then what's left over? 3x times what makes 12x squared? Well, 3 times 4 makes 12, and then x times x makes x squared, so I have an x there. And then 3x times what makes 3x? Well, that's a plus 1. Okay, so there's the first two terms all done. Now the second two terms, there's a negative first, so I need to take that out. And then what's in common with the 8x and the 2? Well, that's simply a 2. Now negative 2 times what makes negative 8x? That's going to be positive 4x. Then negative 2 times what makes a negative 2? That's positive 1. So here are the second two terms, all done. Notice that there is a common term here. There's a 4x plus 1 and a 4x plus 1. So now we're going to do what's called the grouping part. Now, this 3x and this negative 2, since they're both multiplied by 4x plus 1, they can be combined together. So it's 3x minus 2, and then times 4x plus 1. Now, this is completely factored. So you might be saying, well, I know the 3x came from here, the 2 came from here. What about the 4x plus 1? There were two of them, and now there's only one. Well, these parentheses, this is just like doing FOIL backwards. When you multiply this out, the 3x is going to multiply by the 4x and then by the 1, and then the 2 is going to multiply by the 4x and by the 1. So you have a 4x plus 1 that goes with a 3x still, you have a 4x plus 1 that still goes with a negative 2, it's just that these parentheses group it and write it in shorter form. So here's your factored answer, 3x minus 2 times 4x plus 1.